Hi, we are here at Vaag Society, Institute for Art, Science and Technology, and they have a lot of projects on citizens and technology, amongst also projects on air quality. I'm here to interview Gijs Boerwinkel, and let's see if he's here.
Hi.
Hi, Gijs.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
How are you doing? Come in. Well, welcome at Vaag Society.
Thank you very much, Gijs.
So we are located at this moment in the Makers Guild.
Yes.
This is called a guild because people used to host a lot of guilds here back in a couple of hundred years ago. But the overall idea of Vaag Society is that we would like to open up technology and democratize this. Well, this means there's a lot of technology these days around us, influencing us. We're using it very, very handy sometimes, very efficient, but we're not really aware of what's inside of this technology. So what we try to do at Vaag Society is open up this technology.
Yeah.
This can be done physically, like opening up a phone and see what's inside of it,
literally.
But also conceptually, like what is this big internet companies are collecting about us and data-wise, or who's measuring the air quality in the city and why can't we do it ourselves.
So. And are these citizens, like, are they all here?
Well, at the moment they're not, but we're hosting a lot of evenings around certain topics.
Yeah.
For example, we have a FabLab where people can come in and make their own projects, think about new techniques of fabrication.
Yeah.
And we do think it's very useful that people have access to these kinds of things where they can do prototyping of ideas they have during or using the 3D printing machines, or maybe some other stuff they have in mind but they cannot conceptualize. We see that this attitude of making and going back to really physically making stuff is a good attribution to a lot of projects because there's a lot of conceptual thinking about the future, about the smart city, but we see as soon as you invite designers and makers into these kinds of projects, there's a sort of new attitude that is added to projects, which is an attitude from that is about I can make stuff, I can design my own solutions for certain challenges, and I think I'm in control of what I design and what I think of. So this is a lot of times the attitude of makers and designers in the FabLab is really an attribution to some more conceptual projects.
And what kind of stakeholders do you collaborate with usually?
Well, this really much depends on the topic we're working on. For example, in the smart city domain, we work a lot with the municipality and research institutes like AMS.
Yes.
And I think these are particularly parties that are very interested in the citizen narrative or the democratizing of technology narrative. And we use fab labs or open makerspaces to add this narrative to the discussion. For example, smart city is about very big infrastructural projects. But we think that smart citizen or the approach from a smart citizen is a very good added value to the smart city when they have access to technology to design their own smart city and their own environment. And this is where a space where we use this to prototype these kinds of issues. And upstairs we have a textile lab. So this is also an example where we try to come up with alternatives for existing industries or existing production schemes.
Thanks for showing us around here.
You're welcome.